brought to you by Penguin.
Be more human. How to transform your lifestyle for optimum health, happiness, and vitality. By me, Tony Riddle. Preface. It's 2014, and I'm standing in the disused London Scotland Railway ticket hall that I've spent the last few years converting into my gym. Around me are my trainers, coaches, and movement specialists. Around me, I can see the product of my life's work and the realization of my dreams. I'm teaching a class about being more human and how to move the body as nature intended. It's a philosophy I've been developing and living for decades. I should feel complete, but I don't. Suddenly, a train thunders overhead. As the gym is attached to a railway platform, this isn't unusual. All day, every day, trains hurtle past, rattling the equipment and vibrating the floor. It's an event so commonplace that no one really pays attention to it. Yet something about this train, at this time, hits me hard. A feeling of momentous awakening cuts me off mid-sentence and almost knocks me over. It's as though my entire life has been building to this very second. As the noise and vibrations grow more intense, shaking the walls, the strip lighting flickers and the bars on the windows tremble. Somewhere deep inside, I'm hit with a sudden bolt of clarity. Standing silently in front of my gym class, I feel like the train is thundering into the depths of my unconscious, and I begin to see my life and the memories and stories I've told myself flash before me. I see the lack, the untruths, the struggles and frustrations. And finally, I arrive at the impossible truth. I was a fraud. I'd been conning everyone, and worst of all, I'd been conning myself. It was time to wake up. For all my trying, I was not healthy or content. How had this happened? I'd been striving for conventional success my whole life. I believed that owning a business, a house, a car, and having a family would bring me happiness. I'd followed the socially accepted steps towards success, embodied the conventions, gone to school, did a stint in the army, become a personal trainer, a Pilates teacher, a movement coach, set up my own gym. I'd made it, lived and breathed the human laboratory, and yet it wasn't working. I'd watched my friends, family, and community comply and suffer the same challenges. Yet I still believed in the promised satisfaction that complying should bring. So why did I feel so unsuccessful when, really, I'd 100% achieved what from the outside looked like the definition of success? Yes, I'd built a business, bought a house, had a family. But I felt like a failure. I couldn't help asking myself, was it just me who felt such disconnection? I'd set up my gym to help people strip back their lives and live more simply, as nature intended. But as the train rattled overhead, I had to accept that I was failing. And I had to question why. I had to strip back my pride and ego to reveal my true vulnerable self. The train forced me to ask myself, what is it that makes a successful human in the modern world? I had to face up to the fact that it sure as hell wasn't what I'd been doing up until that point. I had been chasing the wrong sort of success, the money-driven modern world view, which takes no account of true wellness, emotions, or spirituality. Yet each of these is needed to be a healthy, happy, and truly successful human being. At my moment of realization, I was 38 years old and feeling the consequences of my own unnatural lifestyle. I owned a gym, yet my finances were in a mess. In recklessly striving to stay afloat and maintain the illusion of success, I barely saw my wife and two small daughters. Any remaining energy outside of that was being driven into pacifying drugs and drink to numb the guilt, shame, and pain. I was living the antithesis of everything I believed in, and worse still, I was misguidedly teaching others to do the same. I'd let all of my needs slip aside in the pursuit of what I believed to be success. There I was, in an artificially lit, underground room with poor air quality and filled with electromagnetic waves, espousing the pseudo-virtues of rewilding in a completely unnatural environment that was in no way conducive to how human health works in nature. That day marked the beginning of my awakening. That train smashed through my fragile facade of success, exposing my hidden child, self, and his every unmet need. It knocked my ego into humility. Things had to fundamentally change. Tony 2.0 in training. Today, I can see clearly that all this happened not to me, but for me. The old me was quite happy not voicing the full truth of my experiences. I was fine with carefully crafting my tale, filtering the less impressive parts of my story. I would skip over my long-suppressed guilt, shame, embarrassment. I was sparing with the truth. My childhood deformity, my suffering, the pain, aggression, self-harm, drugs, drink, prison, self-hatred, suicidal thoughts, divorce, losing my business and property, the bankruptcy and the breakdown. Before the health, wealth and happiness came a lot of stuff that I was never proud of. It's been one hell of a process deconstructing my old self. Fortunately, I came to realize I had to go through all of it to figure out who the universe had uniquely assigned me to be and how to be of service to others, as Tony 2.0. Within a month of the train-induced epiphany, I'd closed the gym and launched my broken and bankrupt self into what would become a year of immersive, soul-searching workshops, retreats, potent spiritual practices, truth-seeking, and prolific reading. My breakdown breakthrough provided the spark of recognition that I needed to make serious change in my belief systems and my approach to life. I had to put in a lot of graft, internal deep diving, research, unlearning, relearning, and experimentation to work out exactly what those changes had to be and to make them happen. Even with all this knowledge, I was not walking my talk. Then I imagined how others were feeling. Those who didn't have the information or means of implementing it, those born into the compromised environment of the modern world, with no way of knowing that natural health and happiness existed right there within their own being. Right there and then, those people, along with my two small daughters, became my why, the reason beyond myself to be the change. So that was the start of the breaking down of my belief systems. It also awakened an overwhelmingly empowering sense of my own ability to change. There was no place to hide. I could no longer justify following the expected ego-driven route through life. I just wanted to be happy. It was time to get authentic, be more human, be the change, and so I did. Rebooting, reconnecting, rewilding. The breakthrough was excruciating, terrifying. We were bankrupt. My body looked like I'd stepped off the cover of Men's Health. Yet under my skin and muscles, it cried for nourishment. My mind was running on overdrive. I had few supportive friends and barely saw my family. I was at rock bottom. Not a comfortable place for a previously ego-driven man to find himself in. But I was going to relearn how to run barefoot along that rock bottom. The breakthrough gave me an opportunity to reboot, reconnect, and rewild. To put all the knowledge that I'd accumulated until that point, everything I knew but just wasn't living, into practice. I'd been a data gatherer, now it was time to be a hunter-gatherer, in search of a different kind of life template, to seek out the truth. What a blessing a blank canvas is. In my search for the solution, I was going to have to break away from convention and think differently, inside the box of the human laboratory. How could I upgrade my existing environment to make it work for my health and happiness instead of against it? How could I be the change within my own communities? I was going to have to go far away, possibly to the most remote corners of the earth and the deepest memories stored away in my childhood, to places where normality didn't involve a constructed acceptance of physical, emotional, and spiritual melodies. I would need to dig out the deeply buried seeds of wisdom that had planted all those years before, as a barefooted boy when I actively sought out freedom and risk in nature. Times I felt most alive, most myself. Those seeds sent out shoots, developed a trunk, grew branches I could swing from my current existence into one of learning how to grow into a mature, living oak tree of fulfillment and wellness. I would have to establish my true needs and find a new tribe of influence that would help me grow through living rather than misguidingly protecting me from it.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.